Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Today we are making taking the word of God, Joshua 3:5. Joshua 3:5. Sanctify today. Sanctify today. And God will do the miracle for you. God will do the miracle tomorrow for you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Let me ask you, today we are taking very, very powerful the process of purification of our soul. The purification of our soul. We are taking the purification of our soul. How we purify our soul? Purification of the soul, whatever it is, one of the reason sometimes people ask, we experience setback, failures and everything. The reason for the blocks, it is the hurt, some kind of hurt and pain, it is there in our life. The hurt and pain, it is there in our life. And we have to get rid of from this all the pain and hurt, all the suppressed emotion, depressed emotions, everything, we have to release it. And during my healing prayers with the people, one thing I noticed throughout my life, for the last so many years in the healing ministry, the reason for the sickness, it is because of the hurt, the pain, the suppressed, oppressed, depressed emotions that is having. Maybe the hurt, it is there in the life, the pain, it is there, not able to forgive it. And that is the reason people going through the, that suppressed emotion, it is disturbed all the energy, all the emotions in our body and contaminate all the energy aspect, and it is converted into poison into our body, and it is creating the sickness, especially the cancer sicknesses and all. And I have noticed it. It is because of one reason, it is the hurt. So that is why if anyone wanted to receive the healing, this foundation, it is Jesus, the Bible says, sanctify today. You have to forgive it. You have to forgive it. Once you forgive unconditionally, when you, once you surrender all the pain and hurt to Jesus, and release all the hurt and pain at the feet of the Lord, the mind is set free. When the mind is set free, you can receive the miracle, healing and wonders. The heaven is open when we forgive it. Now, I invite this power of forgiveness, we deal it today. Power of forgiveness, we deal it. And I invite Captain Sanjay. He will take the first, he will take it, the aspect of forgiveness. Brother?
Yeah, Mother, please make me co-host.
Yeah. You tell me how to make, okay.
Go to participants.
Go to the participants.
Yeah, and then go to my name.
I went to your name.
And when you go the put the mouse on my name, you will get more. You click on that more.
Okay. Thank you,
Father.
Okay, welcome, brother. You can begin it.
Yes,
and how to heal our emotions and feeling and unconditional forgiveness.
Yes, Father. Thank you. Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters. I will just mute everybody. Muting everybody. Father, if you want to speak also, you are on mute. You may please unmute yourself if you want to speak. Okay, I will share screen. The agenda for today, brothers and sisters, let us praise the Lord Jesus Christ who has invited us this evening. I'm sure there are going to be a mighty forgiveness happening today. I pray that every one of you is going to be able to forgive. And forgiveness is going to bring about major healing into your life in all areas, whether it is relationship, whether it is health, your any sickness, disease, or any emotional trauma that you are going through, or you are going through any spiritual challenges, or you are having relationship issues, or if you are having any financial problems, or you are having any sin in your life, habitual sin, mortal sin, which you cannot give up, or even if you feel that there is any oppression, obsession, or possession in your life, that devil is playing a part in your life, even that will be released totally and completely today. With this intention, I come with the blessings of Father and the anointing of the Holy Spirit of Father Zacharias, my spiritual director, upon my head. And virtually and spiritually, I receive his blessings. And with this anointing and charism of praying for forgiveness, I pray for you. So let us go ahead. What the agenda will be, that I will share my screen. I will just show you 4 or 5 slides, and in which I will show you what Pope Francis tells us about forgiveness and of families especially. And then we go on to the next step, where I will take you to a very short 10 to 15 minute process of actually forgiving. And I want all of you to type in the chat box what I tell you after this slideshow is over. And I take you to the next session. Before that, I will tell you to type something in the chat box that you have to please type it. That is very important so that you take a decision today. So let me share the screen now and go ahead. Forgiveness is a gift. Forgiveness is a gift that you give to yourself. Forgiveness is not for anybody else. The slide is opening. I'll just let it open.
It is open.
It is open? Okay, fantastic. Forgiveness is a gift you give to yourself. It is a decision. Forgiveness is a decision, and that decision you have to take today. Brothers and sisters, you have to take this decision today, that I take a decision to forgive. It is, you will tell me, if I tell you to forgive, you will say, it is very difficult, brother. It is impossible. I have got hurt so badly. But the Lord Jesus Christ, the Holy Word of God, the Holy Bible, the Word of God, and the teaching of the Catholic Church tells us that you have to forgive. If you want forgiveness for your sins, which is what Jesus gave you by his death on the cross, and from the cross he said, I forgive them. Father, I forgive them, for they do not know what they do. So far, when Jesus could forgive, and he gave us salvation, redemption, eternal life through the forgiveness of our sins by the shedding of his blood, he's telling us, unless you forgive, your father will not forgive. Unless you forgive, your father will not forgive. And we are all believing that the Lord is forgiving us all our sins and setting us free from the cycle of karma and bhoga. He's setting us free from this cycle. So when we want the forgiveness and we want our life to be blessed and we want sanctification today, purification today, we want to be holy so that we can get the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit, the power of the Holy Spirit to work in our lives, it is imperative that we forgive. Forgiveness is impossible. Even I cannot forgive. But when you surrender this decision to the Lord Jesus Christ, to the Holy Spirit, and the Spirit helps you to forgive, that is the best part. Also, Jesus has made, I always say, Jesus made things very easy for us, very simple for us. And he is the master of the saying, which is that for complex problems, you have very simple solutions. For complex problems, you have very simple solutions. For this complex problem of the inability of a human being to forgive. But when he comes to Jesus Christ and asks Jesus Christ to send the Holy Spirit upon him and help him to forgive, then you can forgive. So I'm giving you this golden formula which our church gives us, which Jesus Christ himself gives to us. The Holy Spirit is giving us this power that if you want to forgive, if you take a decision today, yes, I want to forgive, and tell the Lord, Lord, help me. I am weak. In my weakness, let your strength be manifested. In my weakness, let your strength be manifested. Then he will give you the gift of forgiving love. Forgiving love. You will be able to forgive unconditionally and love unconditionally. So that is a gift you will give to yourself, because you will receive the healing. You will receive the healing in all areas of your life. That is 100% true. That is the word of God, not anybody else saying this. So next we go to a very, very simple definition of what is forgiveness. Forgiveness is often defined as an individual, voluntary, internal process of letting go of the feelings and thoughts of resentment, bitterness, anger, and the need for vengeance and retribution towards someone who we believe has wronged us, including ourselves. So we have to forgive ourselves also. Father said, look into the mirror and say, I love you. Yes, I forgive myself also. That is very important. And you have to forgive everybody. It is an individual voluntary process. Let go. Jaane do. Jaane do. Jaane do. This is what Pope Francis tells us. Pope Francis tells us that a family is a place of forgiveness. Whether it be our own family, whether the parish family, whether the prayer group family, or the family of Catholics, Christians, or the family of the whole of our nation, all everywhere is a family and the extended family. There is no perfect family. We do not have perfect parents. We are not perfect. We do not marry a perfect person or have perfect children. We have complaints from each other. We disappoint each other. So there is no healthy marriage or healthy family without exercise of forgiveness. Only when the Spirit of the Lord is there with you, you can forgive. And if you don't forgive, there will be bitterness and breaking down of relationships. Forgiveness is vital to our emotional health also and spiritual survival. Without forgiveness, the family becomes an arena of conflict and a stronghold of hurt. Without forgiveness, the family becomes ill. The relationship starts suffering. It is diseased. Forgiveness is the asepsis of the soul. That means the soul is freed from all impurities, all infections, all bacteria, all kinds of negative influences which are there in the soul. Forgiveness is the asepsis. It cleanses totally. It makes it clean, purified, white as snow. It is also the cleansing of the mind takes place and the liberation of the heart. Your heart becomes very light. Otherwise, you always have a heavy heart. Whoever does not forgive does not have peace in the soul nor communion with God. If you want to have a communion with God, when Father is doing the meditation in the morning, you sometimes may be feeling, why Father is saying, 1, 2, 3, I enter into Jesus. Jesus, I enter into the heart of Jesus. Why I'm not feeling like that? Check in your mind and into your background and see, do I have to forgive somebody? If you forgive, you will immediately receive the communion. You will become in communion with God immediately. Jesus will be there in your heart and you will be in the sacred heart of Jesus. You will become one. Your nature, character, behavior, attitude, and appearance will be transformed into that of Jesus Christ. Understand this. Your nature, character, behavior, attitude, and even your appearance will become like Jesus Christ. People will tell you why you're looking like Jesus Christ. You are behaving like Jesus Christ. That is what my wife, when the first time she met Father Jodh Betty uncle, and she came out and told me, this must be like, Jesus must be looking like this only, behaving like this only. So this is the power of the anointed person. Okay. And many people also told me that Father Zacharias, when we meet him, we feel so good. He's like Jesus only is telling us and we are getting healed. So that is the power of the anointed person, as especially an anointed priest who is the chosen one of the Lord. So hurt is a poison that intoxicates and kills. And hurt, you know, always hurts you. You are actually harming yourself if you don't forgive. So keeping heartache in the heart is self-destructive. It is called autophagy. It's a, you are killing yourself only. As if you are enjoying that killing. Those who do not forgive are physically, emotionally, and spiritually ill. You will have physical problem. Many people, when they forgive, they get up from the wheelchair and start walking. That is the power of forgiveness, because it is a divine gift from God. And family must be a place of life, not of death. It must be a territory of cure, not of illness. Stage of forgiveness and not guilt. Forgiveness brings joy. Where sorrow has produced sadness, forgiveness brings joy. And it brings healing where sorrow has caused disease. This is all thing which I have told you is from Pope Francis. Pope Francis has given this in his one of his talks. So 10 reasons I will just briefly go through why you should forgive those. It helps you to get free. It helps you to move forward in your life. It begins your healing process in body, mind, and soul. It removes the anger and malice from your heart. You are no longer giving someone else authority over your mind. You will have peace of mind. You will have forgiveness, power to forgive. And it is the best revenge. Word of God says, when you forgive, when you pray, when you bless for other people and do good to them, you are heaping burning coals upon their head. So it is the best revenge. Don't worry, you have taken your revenge once you forgive. And forgiveness is life's teacher, one of the greatest teachers, helps us to release the victim mentality. Victim mentality means, oh, I am always in trouble. Everybody is cheating me. Everybody is hurting me. Everybody has done this to me. All my family, all my people are hurting me, harming me. Victim mentality goes, you come into the power of the Lord Jesus Christ. And these are the 9 profound benefits. It reduces the negative effect and depressive symptoms. If you are feeling depressive and you do not have the joy of the Lord, then you have to forgive. See where you have to forgive. And I will take you through that process. You start thinking positively. Your relationships are restored. Anxiety is gone. Spiritual life becomes very strong. Self-esteem. You feel strong. I have got self-esteem. It gives you a hope. There is a hope in your life. Greater capacity for conflict management. When there is conflict, we all suffer conflict management. This gives a greater capacity for conflict management and ability to cope with stress and find relief. So this is just a few affirmations which I take normally every day. And I forgive unconditionally, love unconditionally, bless unconditionally, pray unconditionally, do good unconditionally. I release all the hurts. I am set free. I am a peaceful soul. Now I will stop share and I'll ask you before I start the session, with short session only, 10 minutes or so, I want you to type in the chat box, I decide to forgive. I decide to forgive. I forgive. Even if you type I forgive, that is good enough. Put it in the chat box, I forgive. That is a decision you are taking. You have to take this decision. Unless you affirm this, unless you bring it out from verbally or in the chat, your body has to come out with that affirmation. I decide to forgive. I decide to forgive. I decide to forgive. I cannot forgive. I know. But I take a decision today. I take a decision today. I take a decision today. I forgive. I forgive. Lord, help me. Jesus, help me. Jesus, help me. Jesus, help me. Holy Spirit, help me. Holy Spirit, help me. I forgive. I forgive. I decide to forgive. I decide to forgive. I know I'm very angry. That person has murdered me, killed me, murdered my relative, so-and-so, so-and-so. But I still decide to forgive. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Good, good. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So many more people, just keep putting, I forgive, I take decide to forgive, I take decision to forgive, unconditionally, no conditions attached, put it in the chat box, show your willingness to forgive should be there, first step towards the Lord Jesus Christ, and he will take 1,000 steps towards you. Take the first step, go ahead, praise the Lord, we will take the questions and answers later, Nelly and Kavita.
I don't know. It's my mistake.
We will take the question. Father will take the question later on. Right now, we will go ahead with the session. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. 59, 60 out of 96 people. Still 30 people to go. I'll give you half a minute more. 30 seconds. Please type. I decide to forgive unconditionally. This is the power of, you know, when everybody takes a decision together. What Father used to teach us. This is the mob power. This is the power of the community. When we decide to forgive, there will be mighty signs and wonders, miracles and healings. You know, mighty.
How
signs.
Do I type this on what, brother? I'm not getting. I can't type it.
Okay, where don't do worry. You can say with your mouth now. Oh, you have
okay, I decide to forgive.
Very good. Nina Gupta ji, God bless you. Thank you.
I decide to forgive.
Very good, Nelly. Thank you. God bless you.
I forgive everybody who hurt me.
Thank you. Go ahead. 75 and plus 3, 79.
Fantastic. I forgive everybody unconditionally.
This is the building of the Holy Spirit, you know. 100 people, if they are going to decide to forgive today, there will be massive progress happening in this country. The whole church will be shaken up today. So many people deciding in the name of Jesus to forgive unconditionally. We are seeing a miracle already. So many people. Which is going, you know, right now, when we decide to forgive. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 85 plus. 4 or 5 people have given verbal, almost 90. Only very few people have. Father, this is a miracle we are seeing. Father, we are seeing miracles. Let us give the Lord a big hand. Almost all the people are univocally in one voice saying, I decide to forgive. Satan is defeated in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I will mute all of you again and then let us go ahead. Go ahead with a short session. Close your eyes. Please close your eyes. Sit in the meditation position with your back straight, spine straight, head up. Close your eyes. Put your hands on your thighs in the Dhyan Mudra position with your thumb and your index finger together on your thighs. Close your eyes and relax deeply. Relax deeply. Relax deeply. Relax deeply. As I count from 5 to 1, you are going down into the earth, the center of the earth, and there you are going to be getting into the time machine. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, relax. And open the door of the time machine, and all of you enter into this time machine. And this time machine is going to take you back in time. Right now it is taking you back in time. Close your eyes and imagine. Visualize it. Visualize you are at the center of the earth and this time machine, you are sitting in it. And this time machine is taking you to the time you were conceived in your mother's womb. If anybody is wearing spectacles, please remove. And you are going to the time when you were conceived, in the mother's womb, when your father and mother met and the conception took place. You are just getting in the mother's womb. You were formed, conceived at that time, at that moment. You are reaching that moment and you are seeing that there is so much of chaos. So much of chaos. Were your parents really in the right frame of mind, spiritually and emotionally, when you became, when they caught you as a pregnancy, when you were conceived? Or were you a product of lust or of love? Were you an accident? Were you a child which they did not want, but it happened? For all those moments, whatever may be have been the situation, we do not know. But we take a decision today and we say, I forgive unconditionally. I forgive unconditionally. We travel in that time machine to the day when you were actually born. The day you were born. So beautiful. You were there born and everybody was looking for to you. Everybody was looking at you in the maternity home where you were born, in the hospital where you were born. Everybody came to look at you. First, your mother looked at you, your father looked at you, your grandparents from both the sides looked at you, and so many other people. Was there any rejection at that time? Did your mother think, oh, why did I get a boy? I wanted a girl. Or did the father think, oh, why this is a girl? I wanted a boy. What were the grandparents thinking at that time? And they were saying very loudly when you were born, oh, this lady, this mother, she only could produce a daughter. But we wanted a son for our family to grow, for our name to grow. And why she produced this? What kind of woman is it? And blaming your father and mother and blaming you for having come into this world. Some people also came after some time and everybody is saying, why this child is so dark? Why so fair? Why so ugly? Why so beautiful? Either way. And that is causing a trauma in your brain. Either it is causing negative emotions or it is causing an emotion of pride that, yes, I am better, more beautiful than everybody else. Maybe pride is coming into you. Maybe rejection is coming. Maybe dejection is coming. Feelings are coming which are harming your subconscious mind. Your mind is hurt. Your subconscious mind is getting hurt. And now as we are in that position, the Lord Jesus Christ has taken there. By the power of the Holy Spirit, we have reached there. And Jesus, who is the same yesterday, today and forever, we ask him, Jesus, with your precious blood, wash away all these negative things from my subconscious mind. Cleanse me. Clean all those moments and the effect those moments are having in my life. Lord Jesus, cleanse everything with your precious blood. I decide that I forgive unconditionally. And as we move forward, we go to the next stage of our life between our birth, 0 to 4 years old, when we were just growing up. And our subconscious mind was the most open to everything. Anything that was being said, thought, or done was getting straight into our subconscious mind. And there were so many experiences, so many things, so many fights between my parents, so many fights between my mother and my grandmother, between the daughter-in-law and mother-in-law. And so many times I was blamed, I was hated, I was compared with other children. I was compared with my cousins, with my neighbors. So many times wrong things were said to me. So many times things which hurt me or hurt my parents or hurt my people. And all that got embedded and hurt me very badly. And it has had a negative effect in my life. I asked the Lord Jesus Christ to wash all these moments clean, white as snow, with his precious blood, as I take a decision to forgive unconditionally. Hallelujah. Go to the next stage of life between 4 to the age of 7, when we are entering into school and we are meeting new and new people, so many new students and so many new teachers are coming into our life. As we are going traveling, we are meeting so many people during our travel to the school and coming back from school. Who is hurting us? Are my fellow students hurting me, talking negative about me, negative about my parents? Are the teachers giving me extra partial treatment, good treatment, better treatment than others? So I'm feeling very proud. Is that pride in me now also? Are the teachers blaming me for things which I have not done, spreading lies about me, hurting me? And I'm coming home and telling my parents also, nobody is willing to listen to me. They don't want to listen. They don't have time for me. Everybody is just ignoring me, no attention to me at this age because they think I'm too small and I cannot say anything. And those hurts that are there have really, really harmed me and hurt me and affecting me today. Maybe somebody, you know, used bad touch against me. Somebody touched me in a bad manner. Somebody tried to abuse me at that age. I was so depressed. I didn't know what to do. I did not even understand what they were trying to do to me. And I wanted to tell my parents, but nobody was listening to me. Lord Jesus, I take your precious sacred blood and cleanse all these moments. Please clean me, cleanse me white as snow. And I go forward, Lord, taking this decision that I decide to forgive each and every person during that age. As we go to the next stage of life from 7 to the age of 12, when we were just growing up and coming into our puberty and coming into our early growth, and we were growing, our bodies were changing, minds were changing. Again, so many negative experiences we had. So many times people are trying to talk to me in a very negative manner, hurt me, abuse me, touch me badly. So many people are, even my own family members, my cousins, sometimes my uncles, aunts are trying to touch me badly. I don't know what is happening at all. So many people are abusing me. My family members, my parents themselves are not talking to me. My brothers and sisters are hurting me. They are fighting with me. They are hitting me. Violence is there. They are giving me bad language, using abusive words for me. I cannot do anything about it. I have been so hurt. It put me into a shell. I cannot open up in front of everybody and anybody. And it's affecting me. I ask the Lord Jesus Christ to take his precious blood and wash me clean, totally white as snow. As I take a decision, I forgive unconditionally. And as I grow into my teenage from the age of 13 to 19, as I'm growing, my body is growing and I'm forming new and new relationships. I'm meeting people, boys and girls from the opposite sex, and I want to have relationships with them. I want to be close to them. But I know my teachings are good. I do not want to be abusive, but I am falling into traps. I'm getting so emotionally attached. And I want to share my feelings with my mother. There are so many changes happening in my life. As a boy, I'm growing this mustache. I'm feeling so dirty about it. What is this black mark on my face? And I'm asking my mother and father. And they say, "Boy, you are growing. Don't worry. Everything, it happens to everybody." As a girl, I'm getting so many changes. I'm entering into adolescence. There are so many changes. So many things are happening to me. But I cannot talk to anybody. They are all abusing me. They are all telling me wrong things. They are just neglecting me. Nobody wants to listen to my emotions. The friendships that I am making, nobody is listening to me. I'm getting hurt by my fellow students, by my fellow colleagues, by my fellow companions of the opposite sex also. They are hurting me. They are taking advantage of me. I am so simple and they are taking advantage of me. And I am also so rash at times. I take decision very impulsively. All these things have hurt me very badly in these young ages. People took advantage of me. People hurt me very badly. I tell Jesus Christ right now to, with his precious blood, to wash each and every moment and make me white as snow as I take a decision that I forgive unconditionally. We go on to the next stage between 19 to 25 years of age, when we are growing and we are studying and we are getting our degrees and we are getting into early marriage. And our relationships are forming. And so many good things. Life has got such a beautiful future. Such beautiful dreams. But things are getting shattered at times. I am not getting the right life partner. Something is wrong. I get married by force. I am getting into wrong relationship. I am getting into wrong marriages. My desires are strong. So people are taking advantage of me. My colleagues, my school teachers, professors. I am not able to succeed. I am not getting the admission into the right companies, into the right colleges. In the campus also, I am rejected. I am not able to study because I am distracted so much by so many people and their negative comments. So many negative experiences I am having. I feel so rejected, so dejected, so depressed, so oppressed. I am just moving forward. I really don't know what's happening to me. And I ask the Lord Jesus Christ, all those people who have hurt me and harmed me in any fashion, Lord, please, I forgive them. Please wash those moments white as snow. Cleanse me, purify me, sanctify me as I take the decision to forgive unconditionally. We move on from the age of 25 to 40 years of age, where the career growth is there, where the family growth is there, where the children are born. And as I'm going into my life, my parents are not supporting me also. They feel that I have not been a successful story at all. My wife or my husband is thinking that I am not successful. I am not behaving properly. I am just being very selfish. And they are rejecting me. Or my wife is having an affair with somebody else. And I am so hurt. I am so badly hurt by...
Brother, we are not getting your voice.
Sorry, I am also.
Brother,
we go through this 25 to 40 years again, where there are so many rejections and dejections because of the marriage and because of the career and because of the new friends that I'm making. I'm not getting the right breaks. There is politics in the office. There is politics among our friends. There is politics at home. There is an issue between mother-in-law and daughter-in-law. And there are the parental interferences in our marriage. And when I am not successful in my marriage, my spouse is not supporting me. My husband, my wife also thinks I am useless. And my children, as they are growing also a little bit more, as I am reaching my 35 to 38 years, children growing up more also, they feel I am unsuccessful. They feel they are rejecting me. They are telling me on my face and I feel very hurt. Nobody supports me in my family and I am falling into wrong relationships. My husband, my wife is falling into wrong outside extramarital relationships and that is really hurting me. I've tried to be so loving, so kind and build up my family, but all these events have really hurt me. My children have hurt me. My parents have hurt me. My colleagues have hurt me. My bosses have hurt me. My company employers have hurt me. I've really been affected so badly and I'm so depressed because of that. And I've been totally unsuccessful because of these negative feelings. And I ask the Lord Jesus Christ to take his precious blood and wash me clean. The Lord, same yesterday and today, Lord, wash me clean. And I pray and I take a decision to forgive unconditionally. As we move to the next stage between 40 and 59, 40 and 59, 60, before you are actually retiring, this is the critical stage of your life where you should be growing into promotions in your career, into your life, into your deeper attachment with your family, with your wife, with your husband. And as you are growing also, you are facing so many changes in your physical body. You are not as strong. You are not as energetic. You are feeling weak, but people are not understanding you. As a wife, I am feeling very, very hurt. I'm growing into my age and coming into my premenopausal stage. My husband doesn't understand me. He thinks I'm gone mad. And my wife is not understanding me because I am feeling a little incompetent in my life. So my wife also is rejecting me. My wife has gone and had an affair. My husband has gone and had an affair outside and no attention to me. We are like strangers in our home. Our marriage has got affected very badly, though we are staying at home. My parents are blaming me for being unsuccessful. My children are asking me for money and their good needs and all. So many things they want, but I cannot give them, but I'm not so successful. And I feel whenever I come home, I'm getting all the wrong emotions coming to me and hurtful feelings. My wife has left me and gone. My husband has gone, left me and gone for another woman. And he is not staying with me. My wife has left me and gone with another man. My children have rejected me totally. My parents, my bosses are not giving me the promotions. I deserved so much. And I have been so badly hurt. I ask the Lord Jesus Christ with his precious blood to wash me clean and cleanse me totally and completely as I take a decision to forgive unconditionally. As I go forward from the age of 60 onwards, those who are there in that stage and have been feeling rejection and dejection and neglect from their children or from the time where you have given everything to your children and now the children are not looking after you, and all the hard work that you had done, you could not build up a life for yourself, no support for yourself. Now people are laughing at you, your children are laughing at you, your wife or your husband is also making fun of you and considering you an old person, and your all colleagues also, you have retired now, but all your friends who are there are not giving you the right importance. Even you are working on the doing social media activities, people on the social media also neglecting you, rejecting you, not giving importance to your past, and you feel, why I am like that? I was so well educated and everything. Why everybody has gone against me? And this last years of my life to this, to the end of my life also is so traumatic. I take a decision today to forgive unconditionally, and I ask the Lord to forgive each and everything and renew my youth like an eagle and make me young once again, energetic once again by washing everything clean, and I begin a new life today. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I forgive unconditionally. I forgive unconditionally. I am set free. If Jesus sets me free, I am free indeed. If Jesus sets me free, I am free indeed. Mother Mary, pray for me. Saint Joseph, pray for me. All the angels and saints, pray for me. My guardian angel, help me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. I count 1 to 5. Slowly come back. Open your eyes as I count and rub your hands. 1, 2, 3. I forgive unconditionally each and every person who has hurt me. Is helping me. Jesus is helping me. I decide to forgive. Today I am set free. Today I am healed in all 6 areas of my life. Today is a new day for me. Today is a day of miracles. Today is the day of my healing. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Gratitude, Lord. Gratitude, Lord. I believe. I receive. I believe. I receive. I believe. I receive. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 4, 5. Rub your hands. Put them on your eyes. Open your eyes. Slowly come back. Hallelujah. 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 In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you, Father. Father, you please take over.
Yeah, thank you, thank you. Let me ask you, did I take the speak about Dr. Joe Vitale? Any days I had spoke about Joe Vitale, I release all the...
Yes.
You spoke Father. About Joe Vitale, yes. You did speak about Joe Vitale, yes.
Yes, yes, Father, you spoke, yes.
I wanted to just part of this forgiveness prayer. It is very central point of spirituality in the Catholic Church. The forgiveness, the nature of God. It is God is unconditionally forgive all the areas of our life. And Jesus manifested his nature, character, behavior in the unconditional forgiveness. This unconditional forgiveness, it has to be everyday part of everyday life. Every day we have to say, I release all the hurt. I forgive unconditionally. I am set free. I am peaceful. Every day you have to confess. This faith affirmation, brother can put it in the group. And you have to go on, repeat and repeat and repeat. How this, I remember once I was in the, I was preaching for great criminals on the feast of, I don't remember, many years back. Either Christmas or Easter times, I had to visit, I had to go with the team, Jesus, the prison ministry of India. I had to visit, I had to give a message in the central jail. And I was thinking, what I am going to preach. And when I reached there, Holy Spirit inspired, I took the cross. I told them, even if you raise your hands against God, even if you raise your hands against God and kill God, still God is ready to forgive you. Still God is ready to forgive you. That is the message of the cross. Even if you raise your hands against God and kill God, still God is ready to forgive you. That is the nature of God. That is the character of Jesus. And Jesus teaching this message of the salvation. Salvation comes. This unconditional forgiveness. I spoke to you about one day about Joe Vitale. Joe Vitale, he's a doctor, and he brought this unconditional forgiveness into the secular world in a special context. He was working in a central jail, and central jail related to the mental patients. The whole patients are mentally diseased person, mental patients. Can you imagine? And he asked myself, why God has brought me here? And that is the context he is presenting. And he understood why the people have come to this mental hospital. Because our human mind has a capacity. When the pain is, the hurt, the emotional trauma, the pain, the hurt, and deep sorrow, when once it is become unbearable, the suppressed, oppressed, depressed emotions, when it get burst out, when the gas cylinder is filled, when it is become more and more full, it get burst out. The same way our human mind has a capacity, when it is the suppressed emotions, when it is go beyond the limitation, burst out, and they are called mentally sick, mental patients. And that is the reason he understood how I have to work with them. And it is in the whole day he did this prayer. It is through the speaker. It is in the whole hospital. The whole hospital, he understood it is the man is going through the deep rooted, the pain and hurt. And that is why the 24 hours continuously in the hospital, he played this prayer. I am sorry. I am sorry. Please forgive me. Please forgive me. I love you. I thank you. I bless you. Continuously, he was going on praying. I am sorry. Please forgive me. I love you. I thank you. These are the four words he was using. I bless you also. That is a Catholic nature. So we continuously pray. He was giving this prayer. And what happened? Within 3 months, continuously we release it. I release all the hurt. I forgive unconditionally. I am set free. I am peaceful. The pressure is coming down. Pressure is coming down. That anchor, that stress, that revenge, the retaliation. The moment you continuously, brother was telling us, it is in the moment of decision. The destiny is created. It is in the moment of decision. The destiny is created. And that is why we take a decision. Say, I release all the hurt. I forgive. I am sorry. Please forgive me. I love you. I thank you. Continuously repeated and repeated. Thousands and thousands times. The lakhs and lakhs time continuously. He went on. And all the pressure is released. And the pressure is released. And that is the reason he wrote his book. Zero Limit. Zero Limit. The pressure is come. All the pressure is come down. It is released. It is released. Everything it is released out. And within 3 months, the whole hospital is closed down. The whole hospital, only because of this prayer forgiveness. That is the way it became so internationally famous. internationally famous. This prayer, it became, even if you type in the YouTube, in the YouTube it is there. Just you type in Hoppapa prayer, H-O-O-P. You can just start it. Immediately the prayer will come. Simple prayer of the whole hospital is closed down. Because can a mental patient can pray? Mental patient cannot pray. He is mentally sick. He is out of control of the mind. And he went on praying through the speaker throughout the hospital. Went on, this prayer is repeated and repeated. And I tell you, at least today, half an hour, you pray these healing affirmations. You tell it yourself. I release all the hurt. I forgive unconditionally. I am set free. I am peaceful. I release all the hurt. I forgive. I forgive. I forgive. I release all the hurt. I release all the hurt. I release all the hurt. I forgive. Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Spirit of the Lord is upon me. I release. I forgive unconditionally. I forgive unconditionally. I release all the hurt. I forgive unconditionally. I am set free. I am set free. I am peaceful. May shant hum. May shant hum. I am peaceful. I am set free. I am set free. I am peaceful. I release. This is the one set of prayer that brother was telling in the forgiveness affirmation. Remember this prayer. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. I release all the hurt. You have to surrender. You have to give it away. Give to Jesus. Don't keep it within you. Brother was speaking very when. What is the benefit? The most greatest beneficiary of forgiveness, no one else. You are the person. I am the person. The most beneficiary. And the more you release it, you release unconditionally. The miracle started to happen. Whatever incurable diseases, whatever the cancer, the healing process starts. That all that suppressed energy, that emotionally hurt, it is released. And miraculously healing power started to work on you. I tell all the patients are here, attending here. All are healed. All can receive the miraculous way. Maybe the doctor might have told you only few days. Sometimes the cancer patient used to tell one of my parishioner. First I came to the healing prayer with my parish only. The doctor gave only 4 days. When it is released, invoke the healing and miracle happened. And believe in the word of God. Doctor's word. When you go to the hospital, every time they will tell you, take your ECG, take your blood test, your pressure, everything. All the reports every time change. Why everything every time change? It is the doctor's report, everything, it is a fact. All the fact every time change. But God's word will never ever change. It is the eternal truth. And the word of God says, I am healed. That you believe it. The God's word. God said to me, I am healed. So remember, you can receive the healing. The foundation of this healing is you release all the hurt. And I tell you, if possible, before going to sleep today, at least 20 minutes, you remember all the people. You don't think about anything else also. You just tell it yourself. No need of thinking about it.
Become
patients. They can't think also. But just, it has to go into their heart. And within 3 months, the whole hospital is, it is closed down. All were healed. That is why Dr. Joe Vitale's this prayer of forgiveness, it's world famous. It is there in the YouTube. Hoppapa, you can go through also that also. It is secular way it is presented. Remember, we have Jesus Christ. He showed it on the cross. Even if you raise your hands against God, God is still ready to forgive you. Forgive all the people and say, I am sorry. Please forgive me. I love you. I thank you. I bless you. Going on, repeat these words of whatever that healing that it is releasing you, you can, suitable words you can confess. It is in the faith affirmation, it is there. You can go through, I release all the hurt. I forgive, I am set free. I am set free. I am peaceful. Yes, Lord, I am set free. I am peaceful. Now, when I am set free and peaceful, it is my birthright. I claim my healing. It is a promise you sanctify today. God will do the miracle for you. I forgive. I am healed. I am healed. I remember once in the Tabor Ashram, a man, her daughter was brutally killed and he was full of revenge. Yes, I will retaliate. I will revenge. And he became a mental patient. And when during this inner healing session, he surrendered himself at the cross and he became completely healed. He used to roaming on the retreat center because mentally he was anger, mental patient himself. I wanted to kill him. I wanted to kill him. When he forgave himself, God has healed. Whatever the sickness, remember, I claim, I forgive, I forgive, I forgive. I am healed, I am healed. God bless you, God bless you. Brother Sanjay, such a very powerful way you conducted the inner healing session. Inner healing session, whatever the situation, it is, you done excellent job.
Thank you, Father.
Please tell me the name of please.
Jomita, you can just type it. You just type H-O-O-P. I don't know the full spelling.
Sister Mary, you send.
No, it is
Sister Mary. You send me one private message on my WhatsApp. I will send the PDF to you.
Brother, you can put it
thank
in the
you,
common.
Brother, thank that's you, no problem.
Yeah, I'll put it in the group. I will put the book in the group.
Right? Brother will
okay,
put it
okay, in. Okay. Yes. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Brother.
And pray for me.
Father, please.
We meet again tomorrow morning.
Yes, Father.
God bless you, Father. We will pray for you.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Brother Sanjay.
Thank you, Father.
And the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, now, always, and forever.
Amen.